The Sea Dragon expeditions were really meant for two things. One, to draw attention of the public to the Sargasso Sea, which actually is our home here in Bermuda, and a way to take students out for several days, for up to a week, and to show them that really underneath this incredible ocean surface, there is a lot of life, a very productive and a very unique life that ranges from tiny little microscopic seaweeds and algae all the way to the drifting sargassum, which is home to dozens of very unique organisms that find shelter in it, many of them the juveniles of fishes and of turtles and so on.
The diversity of scientific interest shows just how much we still have to learn from the Sargasso Sea. On the Sea Dragon expeditions, we had two graduate students from the States, we had teachers from Bermuda, and we had staff from the aquarium here who were interested in the Sargasso animals and how to keep them alive in the aquarium.
One of the main reasons we wanted to use the Sea Dragon to go to sea was to go and have an opportunity to sample the Sargasso weed away from Bermuda, to really look at the diversity of life that we find in the Sargasso Sea. A lot of this work was done back in the 70s and 80s and really hadn't been followed through over the last 20 or 25 years. So I've been really trying to find opportunities to go to sea to collect animals and see, are the same species that we recorded back in the 70s and 80s still there in the same numbers? But if we see changes in that sargassum community, that means other animals are going to be disappointed if they show up. They're just not going to find the food resources they need, and that's going to lead to perhaps other changes in the whole Sargasso Sea ecosystem. So that was a really important thing for us to be doing now, is to say who lives out there and is it functioning the same way that we had understood based on past research.
The Sargasso Sea historically has been one of the most traveled, one of the most exploited, one of the most dumped upon oceans. After all, it is a sea without shores. It is an ocean in the middle of an ocean.
I think the average person needs to understand how much we're connected to the Sargasso Sea, that so much of our life here on the island is dependent on animals coming to us that have to have spent time in the Sargasso Sea. The fishes we catch both on our reefs and also offshore on our banks are in some way integrated into the whole system of life out there in the Sargasso Sea. So we have all these different species that have been adapted to living right on the sargassum. They themselves feed on each other, small things like shrimps that feed on smaller animals, the sargassum fish, which hunts and prowls within the sargassum weed to look for things like the shrimps and the crabs. But then seabirds are in there coming to forage. We have fishes that come in as juveniles and sit underneath the mast trying to pick off something to eat. And those small fishes are attracting other predators, larger things like tunas and wahoos and mahi-mahis to come in there. So this remarkable system is just so packed full of life on the surface. It's a really remarkably diverse ecosystem.
Another big surprise came only a few years ago when a tiny little alga, a one-celled alga, was found in the Sargasso Sea. It's been dubbed now the smallest thing that everybody should know of. It produces much of the oxygen in our atmosphere, and it is of great value, of course, to all of us.
At the end of the expeditions, we held a summit where we brought together all of the scientists who had been working in the Sargasso Sea. We had presentations ranging from climate change to local sharks to the ecology of sea turtles. And the presentations were attended by the entire community. It was an extraordinarily rich opportunity for exploring knowledge and for discussion.
Yeah, we have this tiny island, but we are surrounded by this vast expanse. So we really should know more about it, and we should care about it. And just, I think, as we usually care when we go out of the house, what greets us out there, a friendly, healthy, happy environment. This is what we should expect of the Sargasso Sea.
The Sargasso Sea encompasses 5 million square kilometers and is both the front yard and backyard of our island home. Whether we know it or not, we depend at a very basic level on the health of this ecosystem to ensure the survival of Bermuda and for our critical food resources. We need to understand more about the Sargasso Sea and the diverse species that inhabit it. We have an obligation to protect it for future generations so that we can make the best decisions for conservation and use of the resources we rely on. Bermuda is working with the Sargasso Sea Alliance to build international support for the conservation of the Sargasso Sea. Citizen scientists and environment organizations like the Atlantic Conservation Partnership will continue to play key roles as advocates for the protection of our surrounding ocean and in educating Bermudians about the value, benefits, and beauty of the Sargasso Sea.